Hello and welcome to a new tutorial. Today we are talking about capnography and capnometry with the corpuls3T. Verena, there are two methods. One is the mainstream method and the other is the sidestream method. Would you like to briefly explain them to us?
Yes, sure. In principle, we are measuring the carbon dioxide content in the exhaled breath from the patient using the capno. With the corpuls3T, we use the mainstream method, which means we measure the content directly on the measuring cuvette. In contrast with the sidestream method, breath is first extracted and then analysed in the device.
The measured values can be displayed numerically and as a curve. In the respective context menu, the units mmHg and kPa can be changed. In the curve context menu, the display area can also be changed.
Now that we have looked at everything in theory, we of course also want to look at it in practice. You will find the capno in the far right pocket, next to the blood pressure gear. The measuring sensors are here in the front. And the accessories are here in the two smaller pockets. We currently have various measuring cuvettes in here. And some adhesive tape. We have unpacked our measurement cuvettes, and we have two here for independently breathing patients and one for an incubator patient. As always, a complete list of all available measuring cuvettes, as well as further details, can be found in the user manual. We are going to take one for an independently breathing patient and prepare it. It is important here that the arrows on the sensors point forward, and that the triangle on the sensor fits into the triangular recess on the cuvette. And now when we push this together, you can hear how it clicks into place. We will do the same thing on the other side. Now we are prepared for measurement. Ben, can I show you how I would apply this to a patient?
Yes, definitely.
Don't panic, Ben. Two small plastic tubes will be placed inside your nose. And now I will put the cables behind your ears. I'll align it in the middle and fix it in place with the slide. Is that too tight or is it okay?
It's okay.
Very good. Then I will fix the whole thing in place. I have prepared some tape already. I'll put a piece over the adapter on your nose and pieces on your left and right cheeks over the cables. Now it all sits firmly and won't slip. Perfect.
For intubated patients, you use the tube adapter. It is prepared like the nasal adapter, triangle to triangle. It is then placed into the airway. Verena, can you take over for me? Please let us know in the comments where you place the CO2 measurement.
It is very important when measuring CO2 that the cuvette can be changed during ongoing use. When we're finished, we're obviously tidying everything up accordingly. To do so, we'll separate the sensors from the cuvette. This can be disposed of. We'll wind up the cable. It goes into the bag. And we'll put the two sensors in the holder at the front. It is important that the two arrows face each other and that we hear a slight click. Then we're done.
Wonderful. If you enjoyed this, please feel free to leave a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and we will see you next time.
Goodbye.